What's up, guys? This is POTOFGREED, and welcome back to another deck profile on this channel. Today, I want to show you actually a very competitive deck. I think this might have the potential to become tier 1, yet no one plays it. I'm speaking of Monarchs with Warriors, a Warrior Monarch deck. Now, I've gotten the idea for this deck from a guy who ran a very similar build at his locals, and he went undefeated, winning the locals without even bringing a side deck. However, he ran Xerians, and he ran like some weird card choices that I do not necessarily agree with. So I kind of adapted the deck and made it my own build, and yeah, that's what I'm gonna show you now. So let's get right into the deck. So for the monsters, we're running Blackluster Soldier, obviously best monster in the game. And if you can run him, always run him. We're running a lot of light and darks, so there's no point in not running BLS. But yeah, nothing much to be said about this guy. Then we're running Harshad and Jinso. Very genetic tribute monsters, not necessarily monarchs, but very useful in general. They allow you to play very aggressively by dealing piercing damage or negating traps. They're very good targets for Premature Burial or Call of the Haunted. They are light and darks, and they're just very useful in general, so they fit very nicely into the deck, actually. Then we're running three Monarchs. We're running Zaborg, Testalos, and Grandmar. Now, Zaborg is actually my least favorite Monarch, because he kind of has to target an opponent's monster, and you can't summon him without your opponent controlling a monster. But he's a light, so I kind of put him in here, and he works out well on this deck. Grandmar is just one of the most versatile ones, and he can target any spell or trap or monster that is set, so he allows for insane aggressive play. And Testalos is just very useful, like in any situation almost, because your opponent most likely always has a card in hand, so he's like the kind of guy that you can always summon. So yeah, that's my three Monarchs. For the Warriors, we're running two DD Assailants as well as one DD Warrior Lady. Now, you might recognize those out of my Warrior deck profile, my DD Warrior deck profile. And this deck is a bit similar to the other deck, actually. It's kind of like a combination between Monarchs and the DD Warrior deck profile, in a sense that it's very aggressive and it implements Monarchs. So those are just very annoying to deal with for your opponent, and they have good stats. Very versatile, so that's why I'm running them. Now, we're running obviously a few more warriors. We're running two Blade Knights. Blade Knight is great. This deck doesn't play flip monsters itself, but it is very good at dealing with opponents' flip monsters. And Blade Knight is just such a versatile card. It can beat over Parshot, it's a light monster. It's very aggressive, it has good stats, it can beat over flip monsters. It's just super good, and I wouldn't want to miss it in this deck. Now, a card that the guy who originally created the deck wasn't running was the Ninja, but I actually like it a lot, especially nowadays with the Chaos spam. Like, everyone is running Thunder Dragon Chaos with at least two Chaos Sorcerers and VLS. They really have to summon it in attack mode with the monster, and even if it's useless, like even if it has no effect, then it's still just a vanilla with 1800 attack and a light monster, so it's never really dead in the deck. We're running one Mystic Swordsman. As I already said, I really hate flip monsters a lot, and this card helps you deal with them. Sometimes I'm controlling a Blade Knight, and my opponent sets a monster in a trap, and I know that it's like a Sakuretsu armor, so I search that with reinforcements, and then I attack with the Swordsman first. Now, if they want to get off the flip effect, they have to Saku it, and then you only control one monster. Then you can attack with the Blade Knight, and they still don't get off their effect. So, running Blade Knight and Mystic Swordsman might seem a bit over the top, but in this deck it actually works out, and Mystic Swordsman is just a card that a lot of people don't really expect, and that's why it works. And then for our last warrior is Donzalog. That's another card the guy wasn't running. But honestly, it's just so satisfying to get his effect off. He's a dark, and he's a warrior, searchable with reinforcements of the army. which makes him definitely good enough to be run in this deck, and I really search him a lot, and getting him off is just not only satisfying, but it can also really make you get an advantage in the game. Then we're obviously also running a few non-warrior monsters. We're running Breaker, this is just standard. And then two Kaikus and a Skilled Dark Magician. So we're not running Sangan in this deck, as we do not really have a lot of great targets for it, and it has weak stats. This deck really emphasizes on being aggressive and having good beat sticks, so Kaikus naturally fit into the deck. Though I originally wanted to run three, and then I realized I actually only have two copies, so I put in a Skilled Dark Magician, and I originally wanted to replace him, but actually no. Actually, Skilled Dark Magician fits in quite nicely too, as this is a Monarch deck that runs a lot of beat sticks. This deck is not super good against Tsukiyomi. For example, Kaiku can easily be beaten over by Tsukiyomi, Blade Knight, or like a lot of Monarchs can be. But Skilled Dark Magician has very good stats. Like, he's obviously just a vanilla in this deck, a dark vanilla. But after testing this deck, I would actually run 2-1. So that's it for the monsters. For the spells, we're obviously running the Trinity. Everybody knows those. We're running Snatch Steal and Premature. Now, if you followed this channel for a while, you know that I'm not a particularly big fan of Premature Burial or Call of the Haunted. In this deck, we're actually running both. And that is because we have so many good beatsticks or good targets like a Pasha, Jinso, whatever, to target for this. And even if we don't have a good target, we can still use it and then tribute the monster for a Monarch, for example. So it's quite good in this deck, actually. And then your Snatch Steal is pretty obvious. Then we're running Heavy Storm and MST, just generic removal. Two Nobleman of Crossout, also just removal. We're running three Brain Controls and one Soul Exchange. Now, in my Monarch deck, I would run 2-2, but this deck really wants to be aggressive, so we're running 3-1. Also, like a standard Monarch deck doesn't have so many ways with dealing with face down monsters, so Soul Exchange is naturally better in those decks. This deck really forces your opponent to do something because he just gets punished every turn for playing passively. And as soon as your opponent plays actively, Brain Control is just a better option compared to Soul Exchange, so 3-1 actually works out great. And then for the last two spells, we're obviously running two Reinforcements of the Army. Now, this is a warrior deck, you have a lot of great targets, of course you have to run those. So that's it for the spells. For the traps, it's actually nothing special. We're running the big four: Mirror Force, Torrential Ring, and Call of the Haunted. We're running double Sakuretsu armor, also just pretty standard. And then there's a little tech choice, we're running Bottomless Trap Hole. Now, the guy that won the tournament ran one Bottomless, and I don't know, I just stuck with it. I just kept it in, and it works out in the deck. Of course, sometimes it's a bit annoying if your opponent summons Sangan or something, but then again, it also comes in great sometimes. Like, the deck really punishes passive play, so your opponent sometimes is kind of forced to do something, to play active, and playing active usually means they're gonna summon a monster with higher attack, and then Bottomless Trap Hole is actually quite useful. So guys, that's it for the deck. Obviously, it's not nowhere near finished developing. It can be improved further by a lot of different ways. I would love if you tried it out. It really has a very, very good win rate for me, and it makes me think if it's not like a secret tier 1 deck potentially that no one's really using. But yeah, let me know your thoughts about the deck in the comments, and now I'm gonna show you replays, and as always, in the end of the video, after the last replay, there will be a screenshot of the deck so you can copy it if you want to. So yeah, that's it from me for now. Thanks for watching, and see you in the next video. Bye bye. I know.
as a guest.